request Sri Mahavir Prasad Sethi, Chief Consultant, Training and E-Learnings of this institute, has done BE Honours Mechanical from BITS Pilani. He is alumni of the College of Defence Management, Secunderabad, and served the Ministry of Defence, Navy, Indian Navy, and retired as Senior Principal Director. Sri Sethi has served the ISTM as Additional Director. He also served the erstwhile Dr. NCR HRD Institute as Joint Director General. I now request Sri Mahavir Prasad Sethi
to address the gallery.
ASOs who have not only joined the program, but they have joined the government service today. Welcome you all. I also welcome, on behalf of the institute, you will find the young ASOs, that your seniors are sitting in the front row, and that's what you will be few years down the line, maybe a decade. And we welcome all our about to become under secretaries, just for awaiting the formality of completing this course. And we have a group of all lady officers, lady under secretaries of the central government. Welcome you all, ma'am. Thank you. I welcome everybody on this inaugural function of the Direct Recruit Assistant Section Officers Foundation course being organized on behalf of the Institute of Secretariat Training and Management, Government of India. It's an honor for me to present a very, very brief overview of the program, because the detailed overview of the program will be given to the participants by the course director and our team tomorrow. The program is concurrently being organized at the four institutes, namely ISTM, then Haryana Institute of Public Administration, HIPA, Gurgaon, MGCPA, Mahatma Gandhi State Institute of Public Administration, and Marichana Reddy Human Resource Development Institute, Government of Telangana. It's a privilege for us as an institute that DOPT, Government of India, and ISTM have professionally been depending on us to deliver the programs of a professional standards that is expected. The 11-week foundation course for the ASOs aims to familiarize the new recruited ASOs with functioning of the government machinery, business rules, and administrative laws. You will also be given inputs along with exercises to facilitate skill development in respect of office procedures, noting and drafting, central government conduct and CCA rules. Modules related to financial management, budget procedures, and accounting procedures are also included in the FC. These modules will certainly go a long way in equipping the participants with latest developments in the administration in GOI. In addition to rules and regulations based inputs, the program design includes a range of soft skills such as communication, team building, presentation skills. This will facilitate personality development and attitudinal orientation, because we are all public servant, towards effective public service delivery. As a part of experiential learning, the ASOs, all of you, will be deputed and attached with villages for a week, which have been identified, to study socio-economic and institutional aspects of the village, including the schemes that are included under Gram Swaraj Abhiyan, for which big advertisements have been coming, and you might have seen schemes like Ujjwala and Ujala in detail, and also prepare a report, group report as well as individual reports. You will also have a stint of Bharat Darshan for 2 weeks to familiarize with roles played by the public sector organizations, enterprises, trace cultural, historical, and economic development of the region, observe the lifestyle of the people in different regions and develop spirit D corps. Let me share with you, you will be perhaps the first group who will go perhaps on all corners of the country, and that is what being planned. There will be a NGO attachment as a part of the Bharat Darshan, and to inculcate that spirit of giving, we'll also have blood donation camps organized for half days here in the institute, and also some Bharat Swachh Bharat Abhiyan. As part of that, we will also be doing half a day Swachhata Abhiyan here as such. The FC will ensure inculcation of basic tenets of administration and the core values of governance at the entry level, which all of you are joining in the Central Secretariat Service. Let me briefly explain the design context. The foundation training has been designed keeping in view the fact that government service is essentially a public service. It calls upon all of us government servants to display moral courage, empathy, compassion, impartiality, integrity, freedom from prejudice, and commitment to the goals of development, equality, and social justice. And this particular service, about which Mr. Govinda Rajulu will perhaps spend some time, is known for its professionalism and its apolitical nature, being in the heart of the capital, and you will be part of it. A government servant should have professional competence to work in a swift, changing, competitive, and complex environment. This would entail having thorough knowledge of the rules, regulations governing the functioning of the government, organizational environment, culture, and wide range of skills. And the program focuses essentially on three skills, two group of skills: communication skills, comprehension skills, and analytical skills. This will be the focus of the program through the entire period of 11 weeks that you will be here in this institute. The training program will provide you an opportunity to develop basic competencies in comprehension, analytical interpretation, communication, and noting and drafting skills. Village attachment and Bharat Darshan and case review presentation will facilitate building comradey and spirit D corps amongst the participants. The program also endeavors to imbue quality of humanism and development of a multifaceted personality. The process of design and implementation of this particular program provides opportunities for self-development, self-discovery through experiential learning, and also working in groups. Each one of you have proven your merit by successfully coming out of the strenuous selection process of the Staff Selection Commission. And I'm sure you are aware that one of the colleagues who was supposed to have been joined here has already got a rank 2 in the civil services examination. That speaks a volume about the skills that you have and the merit that you have. Now, what is required? What is required is to utilize this learning opportunity. We have laid out the 11 weeks of structure through which you will have a, what we call it as a leapfrog effect, or some people call it a staircase effect of joining government systems and services, where you enter with a particular level of comprehension and requisite skills. Therefore, utilize this opportunity to the fullest, so that when you join central government ministries and departments, you are full of those three tenets of the national training policy. We call them three cores: confident, competent, and committed. Commitment. So we look forward that at the end of 11 weeks, this program will facilitate your journey towards confidence, competence, and commitment, dedicated to the cause of good governance, citizen centricity, and effective public service delivery. Tomorrow, there will be a detailed overview and detailed expectation sharing will take place. Let me just, on a concluding note, what we are looking forward is You have proved your merit. Now, what is required is, for the next 11 weeks, be present. I'm not talking of absentees who will be taken care of in a different way, but we want your presence to be present, because that is the first requisite. We are generally not present in the present, so therefore be present. That is the first essential requisite for any learning and development. It's only those who are present, they are the one, those who are blessed with learning and development. So we look forward that you will be present physically, mentally, and with all your faculties open to imbibe as much lessons as you can in a period of 11 weeks. We are confident that the enthusiasm and your presence will help us to add value to each other, to each one of your colleagues, as an individual, as a group, and as an institution. Wishing you the best of campus life at MCR-HRDI and learning opportunities for being an effective human being and an effective public and common servant. One of the first and foremost cadre training plan to have been adopted by the Government of India. Now, these officers are your seniors, and as a part of what we call it as a level D program, it's a terminology, don't go by that, but it is a design for undersecretaries promotion. So they will get promoted to the post of undersecretaries once they complete this program successfully. The idea is, and which applies to most of you, that the Central Secretariat Service officers hardly go out of so-called NCR, and you spend your full career, you plan and prepare schemes for those who are in the districts and villages. So this particular program is only based on experiential learning, and all the Central Secretariat officers who are here now, who will be becoming under secretaries as soon as they complete, they will be going to district attachment and village attachment for 2 months, study various central schemes, various state schemes, what are the plans, what are the implementation modalities, what are the constraints, what are the replicable model potentials, and what are the good practices. So we also look forward that at some stage you will also be coming here for this program, something similar. And this program, this is the fourth program that we are running in a series. One program is already on, and they will also be going to 2 districts, Warangal Rural and Warangal Urban, from 11th of July. Thank you.
Friends, we now have 2 section officers of Central Secretariat Services. They are undergoing a 10-week training program at MCR-HRDI Institute as part of state attachment. So, Madam will be sharing her experience.
It's a great gathering of young budding officers from all over India with a new career in their life. As you see this as good turning point of your life, I see this as a good moment for Government of India also, as it gets number of young, energetic and enthusiastic officers. The important motto of you people for next 30 years and more should be public service and good governance. I hope that you keep this mantra in your heart always. This is the mantra for service to the government, mantra for service to the country, and mantra for service to the citizens of the country. Assistant section officers at Central Secretariat level play very important functioning of the government and efficient implementation of government programs. We have to perform our job effectively. Government decision making process starts with the files by ASOs, SOs, which leads to the higher officers who process the files further and take decisions. Hence, the services of you people are very, very important. I wish to give you some suggestions to perform your allotted work efficiently in your day-to-day office work. Please read and keep reading books and journals related to your area of work. Next important approach for success in your work is to maintain all files properly to maintain very important papers in a readily available manner. I request you to develop some skill to participate in discussion that will make you to effectively participate in any meetings. With this skill and adequate participation for a meeting, you will be an excellent contributor in the country. Now, I wish to talk about certain responsibilities. As stated in conduct rules, we are government servant for 24 hours, so be prepared for work at any part of the day, at time you have to work odd hours, when parliament session is on and when there is a parliament question. In the recent past, responding to RTI questions became very important. So please be careful, be conversant with RTI Act and relevant rules. You have to be conversant with court procedures also. This will help you and government from unnecessary complications in handling legal issues. So learn basic legal issues. My final few words are about what the government expects from the new batch of ASOs who are going to be ASOs soon. As you expect that this job will change your life altogether, the government also expects you to significantly change the service delivery by the government. As lot of emphasis is given for good governance and smart governance, you have to be proactive in positive service delivery to the citizens of the country. So dedicated and quality work is the only expectation of government from you. I hope you will render the same to the government. Let us all pledge that we will live up to the expectations of the government and contribute significantly for good governance in the country. With this, I again welcome all the ASOs and once again wish you all the very best. I wish everyone you have a very prosperous career and to get many more promotions in your career. I thank everyone for giving me this opportunity to welcome this new batch of ASOs. Thank you very much.
Thank you, ma'am, for the suggestions and advice. I am sure it's well taken by all of you. I now request Ms. Vijaya Chandrasekharan to come and speak.
Congratulations to all of you and welcome to the Central Secretariat Service Cadre. You are joining the Central Service Cadre as assistants now. And as all of you know, India is one of the fastest growing economy in the world and leading in many fields and avenues. And we have lot of work and responsibilities to shoulder to improve it further. We are the pillars of the economy, and to continue to do so and flourish in the world if we do our work with right attitude and vigor. Assistant Section Officer is the first platform in the Central Secretariat Service Cadre. This post is very important as all the decision making process begins at this level. So it is expected all the Assistant Section Officers should have a positive attitude towards their work and should give respect to their seniors, follow their directions and orders, and should always be devoted to their duties. As far as your career progression is concerned, I would like to mention that Central Secretariat Service Cadre prospects of growth is very bright. On completion of 5 years of service, you are eligible for writing the limited departmental examinations, which we have already written and we have come to the next stage. Apart from that, on further completion of stipulated period of service, you become eligible for the next promotion. And in Government of India, not only work is emphasized, but all extra sports and events are also encouraged. Like we have all intra-ministry tournaments in cricket, chess, etc. And apart from all these things, recently adventure sports have also been introduced. And one more thing is DOPT has recently introduced that rotational transfer policy based on which you get the opportunity to work in different ministries and departments of Government of India. Based on these, when you work in different ministries, you come to know the working of each of the ministries and get exposure to all the work of different ministries. And all the section, central secretariat officers are very cordial, cooperative, and are always available to you people whenever and wherever the situation and warrants, and always there to guide you people. So I have given you a brief about the central secretariat service, and without any further fear and any apprehensions, go ahead with your career and have a greater height, go to greater heights, learn as much as you can and work hard and be a role model to your juniors who will be coming in future. And I wish you all the best, and I am sure you'll all do best wherever you are being posted. Best of luck to all of you. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am, very much for sharing your experiences and motivating all of them. I now request C.K. Govind Rajalu, Joint Director,
ISTM, to deliver
his address. So I'm very glad to be here as part of this inauguration functions, as part of ISTM, and good evening to all of you. And the most of the thing has been said about the program as well as the service, all other things. That is one of the major thing which has been. And certainly you should be very happy that if people are joining in one of the oldest organized service in 1919 itself, the service which has come up, and then 1942 as imperial service, there was a number of committees has been set up. Gopalaswamy Iyengar committee was there. Then 1962 as a CSS rule which has come up, then the grade up to the four levels of grade it came, and then again in 79 again the director grade, which is the non-functional grade, which has come up, and you have the opportunity up to the level of joint secretary, so one of the great thing, and that is a very good thing in terms of the service. And the off late it has been understood like the cadre training is one of the major thing, as already Sadisar has mentioned. So this is one of the CSS service, the one which is the cadre training plan has been implemented from the foundational level to up to the level of director actually. So that's one of the great thing. And your training also went on. As soon as the cadre training was introduced, it was almost like 24 weeks in the initial stage we did, and then again come down to 16 weeks. It's again, it is linking to the requirement of the organizations and the ministerial requirement as on then. And in 2015 and 16, there was a huge backlog of almost 2000 ADR, ASODR, which supposed to be trained. So from 2015 onwards, actually, we started taking the help of the ATIs, and they also came forward. It's a big process actually went on, because our capacity is maximum we can do in a year. Even that also throughout, if we are doing it, around 300 to 400, which we can do it. That was the capacity. But even ISTM also got the capacity tested. So when I was joined in ISTM in 2006, we used to train maximum of 2,500 people, around 6-7 training in a week. But currently, last year, almost 9,500 training participants have that participated, almost 350 trainings. So we don't go with the numbers, actually we go with the training days, all other thing. So that's the current level actually. That's what the government wants, put the pressure on us, so which we are able to perform. So that's what is going to take place, you guys also. Like, it's a good thing that you people need to know that you are going to be at the center of the India, and it is a head city. There is no transfer is going to be there. That's one of the biggest thing. It's always people feel that is there is something called stability. As Vijay already mentioned, yes, there is a rotational transfer certainly will be there between the ministries and other thing. But that will be always good, because when you move from one place to the other place, there is a knowledge transfer is going to take place, and you learn the new things. And there is a two theory actually on that actually. One is that, okay, there is a the knowledge which is there within you will be moving away actually. So that's why currently there is a big push is going on at every level also. There is a knowledge management system should be placed, so that the person moving from one place to other place, and the existing positions will not have any vacancy or any welcome on that. That's one of the concept. The other thing, as an individual growth, I always say that I conducted a study also, the rotational transfer certainly will help out as the individual thing. But certainly organizations will be deprived of the existing knowledge store actually. Okay. And since you are going to the backbone of the secretarial system, because the thing starts from the assistants level onwards, And whatever the things which you are submitting it, if it is the right perspective, it is submitted and it is seen, even up to the top level without anything, only with the signature, things will get moved up to even the minister level also. So that is the confidence, that's what the level of proficiency which you are people are going to have it. And the other one is that rather than comparing here and there, the moment you join the service, very good service, now you need to concentrate more, but at the same time you need to aim for your career growth also. That we are allowing also. Earlier even we do not give any leave during the training period. But currently, yes, if somebody is going for any higher examinations, all other thing, even 2 days we are permitting it. As part of the things, career growth is one aspect which we are aiming. So that is being given and all. But otherwise, there is no leave and other thing in between. So don't disturb the authority over here. So because without ISCM, nothing also, they will not be providing any leave. Other than any emergency, it is always. But otherwise, formally, there is no leave during this training period. So because you will be getting disturbed actually. Even I was advising the SOs also, like the training means training. The remaining all aspect is something else. Yes, you can come separately also, all other thing. And yes, there is a training going on at 4-5 places. At every place it has its own advantages and disadvantages. So try not to compare with that what is happening in Chandigarh, what is happening at Gurgaon, Hyderabad, all other thing. And but we are trying to maintain, yes, centralized one in terms of that what is being provided, that side also being provided here. That is one of the current thing which we have taken up, and that has put us into some sort of back foot also, like certain things are getting delayed. So I already discussed with SETI sir, because whatever the delay which is occurring because of the change in the process what we have created, all other thing. And at last I'll be requesting you people to be the mostly the current requirement is in terms of the citizen-centric service delivery. That is one of the aspect. I always think, what is the perception like before you joining the government? Or government, what is the general public looks about the government servants, all other thing in terms of their efficiency, performance or whatever it is. I think people should be able to change that perspective, perceptional level what it is there as of now. Because of the youngsters, which you know that what I mean to ask you. And currently, when you are as an outsider, what you are thinking about the inside. So when you are joined the inside, then you should be able to change that perception, anything in the negativity which was there. That was one of the most important thing which is required. So that you can, the people can able to do it, because you have a long service ahead of you, plus 30-35 years of service you are having it. That is one of the thing. And the second aspect is, I am happy to inform that DOPT has done the studies in terms of the competency framework. There are two services only the competency framework has been developed. One is the CSS cadre, and other one is the Indian Corporate Law Service. There are two cadres which has been to identify the gap, mainly like what is the competency required as a assistant section officer and section officer level, as well as up to the level of joint secretary, what are the basic competency. That also we have entered into only the generic level. Because core competency is something that you will be already knowing it. The generic competencies in terms of the citizen related thing actually. As the individuals, when citizens are coming forward to you, what is the thing which is required? So one of the thing came out like something called people first. So this is the competency the person need to have. So it has been like in the scale of 1 to 10, it has been every level it is in terms of the communication, how it should be there, decision making, how it should be there, what owning up the responsibility, how it should be there. So that is available in the DOPT website also. Kindly go through that. Because that is what the requirement which is expected out of you actually. But somehow it is not being, formally it is introduced, but as an institute which we are trying to fill up the gap which is available, but we are not in a position to find out what is the gap. But as an individual, you will be knowing that, okay, this is the competency which is expected, where I am standing in that areas. So you can, certainly can develop that competencies. So kindly go through that. So with these words, I wish you all the best. Come with the flying colors of this 3 months duration of the training, because I hope you all aware that this is going to be a part and parcel of your seniority also going to get added. So I formally thank DGI, MCR, HRD to accept our request, because it is, we were in a dilly-dally when it is going to come, because the court case was going on, all other thing. So with the short notice of time which they accepted, so I am thankful to you sir on behalf of ISCM and other our faculty members. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you sir for sharing a lot of insights on the course.
Sri D.P. Acharya,
Chief Secretary Planning, and is currently the Director General of this institute and ex-officio Special Chief Secretary to Government of Telangana GAD. He is also an avid reader, writer, cartoonist, and a keen researcher of history. Welcome, sir.
I now request our Director General Sri D.P. Acharya to deliver the keynote address.
In a way, it's a very momentous day for many of you today. It marks the beginning of a new chapter and end of another. End of
being a common lay person outside the government and beginning of another chapter in your life where you're part of the government. That marks an important milestone in your life. When you are outside the government, you have the liberty of seeing things in a different perspective, in criticizing things, why things are so slow, why things are not moving, why the government is not responding, why the government is not doing this thing. But now you are part of the government, you have to work out solutions. You are part of the overall machinery, the corridors of power as it's called in Delhi. You see the North Block and South Block, where you'll all be sitting in different ministries. Those are the corridors of power. In fact, you are part of a service which, as Mr. Govindaraj said, was one of the oldest services in India, apart from the ICS and the IP. 1919 it was set up, like the covenanted services of the civil services. Because civil services cannot function without an efficient secretarial support. However efficient the secretary or even the minister or the prime minister is,
the files need to be processed from the town. It has to go through a process of different levels of examination. That's where you matter. But I see many bright young faces
who perhaps would not remain long in this service. I was seeing the profile of many of yours. One of you has already joined IAS as a second rank holder, as a girl. There are many more perhaps would try and attempt other services. But whatever service you are in, don't forget that you are all public servants at different levels. The master is the public. It is not the politician who is the immediate boss or the boss who is working with. You are answerable eventually to the public who pays your salary. Whatever you do, whatever you are processing, is it in the interest of the public? Is it going to help him in whatever way you think? That's the key touchstone for any action. In the central government, to the best of my understanding, the first level of examination is very critical. When an ASO examines the matter, you're expected to be the eyes and ears of your bosses, this secretary, because he or she may not have time to go through all details. You are supposed to be having eye for detail. See everything very carefully, meticulously, and examine things so that you give inputs for decision making. Inputs for decision making are as critical as the decision itself. I have heard many occasions where a good note put up by an ASO or an SO, endorsed by the Joint Secretary, goes right up to the Prime Minister and gets approved. It could lead to certain policies which will change the fate of hundreds and thousands of people. See yourself in that position. You are not mere cogs in the wheel. There could be some kind of a negativity that we don't matter, we are too small a part in the cog in the wheel. But every small screw in that wheel matters. If that is not tight enough, the wheel won't move. Every screw in that wheel matters. So don't consider yourself insignificant. You play that critical, important role, and whatever position you are holding, you can contribute to the decision making, good governance. That's the spirit that we want you to inculcate here. The foundation course is like the basis of your service to instill in you, to inculcate in you
the basic values of governance, of empathy for the people, of feeling for the people. There is often a sense of alienation. Mere paas ek kagaz aaya hua hai, FI aaya hua hai. Why do I bother for this? Let it lie for like that. The sense that Behind every paper, behind every file, there is a family waiting somewhere for justice. There are people waiting for justice.
That's why your seniors who have put in 20 years of service are now being sent to the field. Go and see what the field reality is. Often in sitting in the corridors of power in Delhi, in the high dome building of North Block, South Block, we tend to forget there are people behind files. We take pleasure in rejecting proposals which come from the state, or we don't examine it from the point of view that people want it to be seen. That's where you need to maintain that link with the field and don't become a robot that I will only see from a very narrow, legalistic, technical point of view. Eventually, the law must be honored in letter and spirit. Spirit of the law is also equally important, not mere the letter. So you give solutions from that. That's what, these are the two critical things. If your head and heart are the right places, you follow the law in letter and spirit, you are fearless enough in putting forth facts, every boss will like you perhaps. Hopefully, the boss wants somebody who wants to tell him or her the facts as they are. Most of the bosses would like if you tell them the facts as they are. They may not be pleasant most of the time, but somebody needs to play that role. If everyone wants to become a yes man or a yes woman, things will collapse. That's where the critical role of you people lie. You are all just fresh out of your colleges. Many of you are engineers, I have seen your profile. Many of you have done different kinds of courses. So whatever studies you have had in your career, that's going to in some way help you, guide you. But eventually the right principles of administration, the right spirit of administration should be your touchstone for your action. And the time that you spend here should be used gainfully to inculcate the values and learn things which are basic to administration, your skills for the service. I was told that the course curriculum is mainly exercise based, where you are given case studies of how to process files. Often these days, communication skills are important. Your knowledge of English, and in Delhi, knowledge of Hindi, administrative Hindi, prashasanik Hindi. That's what is important. Many files are in Hindi now. Those of you who are from English medium schools don't have Hindi will have a problem. So we have also arranged Hindi teachers who will guide you, make you learn. So tell us your requirement. We want to fashion you as able. When you go out of this institute, you should feel confident. Yes, I am up to my task. Tell us if you want to learn, want to hone yourself in such a way that you can deliver your task properly. We'd like to help you in that. Help us to help you to become a good public servant. That's the bottom line of this course. In government, if the buck stops with the Prime Minister, buck starts from you in a central department. It's you who started. That is the critical role you play. When a proposal comes, it may come from the Chief Minister of a state. It will be examined by an ASO. At the Government of India level, the proposal will go down to the lowest level with the endorsement of the secretary. File will be put up. There itself, you put it in a different way, the file will go in a different direction. That's where to examine, to understand the curiosity to know things, curiosity to understand things, that's very critical. Often there is a feeling that I have passed this exam, I don't need to learn anything, there is no need for me to read books any longer. I don't have to again mug up different books or read books. That is going to cause downfall to most of your career. Intellectually, you have to be sharp. Keep on honing your skill. As important as your physical the exercises, mental exercise, keeping your brain and your faculties alert is also important. We'd like to help you by some exercises like yoga or meditation. We have arranged that. So please take advantage of that. Unlike other programs which are happening in the country, most of the institutes are in and around Delhi. One is, of course, ISTM is offering 3 of the batches. One is in Haryana, other one is in Punjab. This is perhaps
the only batch like yours, which has come to a different part of India. See the cosmopolitan fusion that Hyderabad offers. Enjoy the place, see the hospitality of the place, and learn from the fusion of cultures that Hyderabad represents. I hope you will get a chance to see the place around. We'll arrange that for you. And most importantly, enjoy your stay. It is not as if we want to make you feel that you are once again like a schoolboy. You should be, there has to be discipline, but you have to enjoy your training. Unless you enjoy your training, you can't learn anything. We will try to help in doing that. That's my bottom line to all my staff also. Let them feel at home. These 11 weeks that you spend here, you should enjoy your stay. You should go back with happy memories. Not as if I will never come back to this institute again. In fact, we would wish you to, want you to come back. We also run the foundation course for the AIS officers, IPS officers, income tax officers. Many of you could come back. The colleague of yours who has got selected for IAS perhaps may come back. So many of you will come back in that capacity. In fact, today's foundation course is the beginning of a series of foundation course that we run in this season in this institute. Yours is the first one, followed by the foundation course for the Group 1 officers of the state government, followed by the foundation course for the All India Service officers that takes place here also, like Mussoorie does. So you are the first of the three foundation courses that we look forward to. We look forward to the young people coming to the institute, fresh ideas, fresh faces. That's what excites all of us. So all the very best to each one of you, and God bless you. Thank you.
Thank you very much, sir, for the valuable inputs and also stressing on the importance of the service and the role of ASOs. I now request Chief Guest Sri APVN Sharma Garu to address the gallery.
Greetings to all of you. As several speakers have mentioned earlier, this is the beginning of a new journey for all of you. Even assuming a few people may go to other services or higher services, this course is certainly going to be useful. And as Mr. Govindarajulu put it, your seniority also is likely to be affected by your performance in the course. So my advice would be to take the course quite seriously. In Government of India, you are the backbone. Unless your note, which is the first note in the file, covers all the facts, the position of law, and precedents, if any, things are not likely to go right at the higher levels. Quite a few of the higher officers do go through the entire correspondence file also. Nevertheless, the note of the ASO and the section officer inputs are critical in any decision making in Government of India. I have had the privilege of working in two departments, and I appreciate the thoroughness with which papers are scrutinized and put up in Government of India. I have had worked in the state government also. Definitely there is a world of a difference in the processing of matters in Government of India. And you are the ones who will be adding to that reputation of efficiency in the years to come. We are going through lots of changes. The Prime Minister, in his address just a few days ago on the Civil Services Day, was referring to the ease of living, which Mr. Acharya has mentioned in a different way as the common man's point of view. Gandhiji also has mentioned that when you take a decision, look at the poorest man, what is it for him? It's very important to know the purpose for which a particular file is being run. Very often we get ourselves lost in the technicalities of sections, provisions, circulars, and are apt to forget the overall purpose for which the proposal is there or a particular case is being dealt with. it's very important never to lose track of the purpose. I'm sure the Institute will give you an excellent exposure, and especially the section officers who are here incidentally could also help you a lot in knowing what the future will be. Now, every decision where it affects for good or bad a section of the population or individuals is ultimately subject to testing in a court of law. You should also have some basic foundations of administrative law. I'm sure at some stage that also will be coming in, maybe in this FC or later in your specialized thing. Otherwise, it's worthwhile for you to go through on your own, and this will be useful wherever you may be, whether in this service or a higher service. You're also, most of you are very young, and I'm sure you're much more savvy with the computers and electronics than the earlier generations of ASOs and section officers and joint secretaries. This will stand you in good stead. The country will definitely move over to electronic file management. Already it is there in different versions, but totally paperless offices also will be in the offing in the coming years. Keep honing your skills, and as Mr. Acharya mentioned, curiosity, the desire to know what is happening and how I can be a part of the some benefit which comes to the public. I have always had a role in this, even though it's a small role. That gives you a lot of satisfaction in the years to come. I wish all of the young participants an excellent time at Hyderabad in the Institute, which has a lot of facilities. It's been built over by successive DGs into what it is today. I'm sure also you will enjoy the heat of Hyderabad and the monsoon, which will come in the month's time. All the very best. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for your kind words. Friends, we now have the memento distribution. DG sir will present hand-woven Pochampalli stoles as a token of appreciation to the section officers, and also a copy of the book Socioeconomic Outlook 2017 titled Reinventing Telangana, a publication of the Planning Department, which provides insights into the progress and milestones achieved in the state of Telangana and will be quite useful for them in the training. We now have vote of thanks proposed by Sri Ram Prasad, course director.
On behalf of the Institute, I thank our chief guest, Sri Apichan Sharma, IAS retired and advisor to governor, for having spared his valuable time and readily accepting to grace the inaugural event. I also thank our esteemed DG Sri BP Acharya, IAS, for giving his valuable time to grace the occasion and giving the keynote address. I thank Sri B. Venkateshwar Rao, IAS and ADG of the Institute, for sparing his valuable time to attend the event. I thank Sri M. P. Sethi, Chief Consultant, Training and E-Learning, for his welcome address and brief overview of the course. I thank Sri K. Govindarajulu, joined at ISTM, for attending and addressing the participants and sharing his thoughts with the newly recruited ASOs. I thank Ms. Parveen Kumari,
and Mrs. Vijaya Chandrasekhar, section officers who are presently undergoing state attachment training, for sharing their experiences with the direct recruit ASOs. I congratulate all the direct recruit ASOs for joining in Central Secretariat service and wish them a very bright future in their career. I thank all the faculty members and staff members of the institute for attending the inaugural event.
Thank you, sir. Ladies and gentlemen, we have come to the end of the inaugural session. I request all of you to kindly rise for the national anthem.